you start off with telling us your name, degree, and what year you're in?
Okay, my name is Zi Meng Ye, and I'm a year two commerce student, majoring in finance and business analytics.
And why would you say you're running for USU board?
Well, I think the reason is really simple because I think I have some good policies to implement and I want to do some things for students and especially for international students because I am one of them. I want to continue to voice for them and do some things for them.
What do you think like the status of international students is at the moment that you want to improve?
You mean the political view?
Political view or like how are international students treated on campus? What kinds of things can the USU do to make their lives on campus better?
I think international students, and for me, I think I'm neutral on the political parties because I don't have any affirmations for liberal or labor, so I'm independent maybe. I think international students are in this side, independent side. I think you mean USU can do something worth for international students?
Yeah.
I think for me, I have some policies for international students. So I just think we can improve the participation rate of the international student and encourage them to engage more into the uni.
Okay, cool. In terms of like political views then, so you said that you're independent. Are you an independent who nonetheless has like political ideas about the USU? Do you have a view on how the USU should be politicized?
I don't have too much experiences on politics, so I'm neutral on this question.
Okay, cool.
Yeah, and what's a USU club or society that you value most or that you think does a really important role for the for students on USU?
I was a member of one society of the USU. Yeah, it's named China Development Society. Yeah, CDS. Yeah.
What did that society do?
This society is how do you say that? It's about China's development and we have some talks and forum to talk about the China's development. And I think we aim to like also international students and local students to know more about China.
Was that a political club?
No.
So in what way did it want to bring about China's development?
I think in this stage we are more focused about cultural.
Okay.
Culture, yeah, just.
So like helping people to understand like Chinese culture.
For example, we have some activities like Chinese traditional festival. Yeah, like this.
Okay, cool. Mm. In terms of like the USU more broadly, I guess, are there some USU policies in the last like couple of years,
mm-hmm.
USU initiatives, which you think are particularly good, which you approve of?
Yeah, I know some international students who are already in the USU board, like Coco or Han Jiesun and Zhi Xianwang.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, they're all international students and they have some policies that I think very beneficial to international students, like the WeChat platform. Actually it's very useful because we can get more information from it about USU, about the uni. Yeah, I think it's very helpful.
Okay.
So of the candidates that are running this year, other than yourself obviously, who are your top three and who do you think you would work well with?
I think all international students are good for the USU campaign. For the top three, I put De Chengsun in the first place, and Janet Ng, and maybe third one for Mike Mao or Lachlan.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Why do you put De Cheng first?
Because I have. I have some communication with De Chen, and I think he had a lot of good ideas. And yeah,
like which one of his ideas do you support?
Yeah, I know he want to. He also want to work for international students.
Mm.
Yeah, so I think it's good.
Mm.
Yeah.
So from reading through, we haven't interviewed Duchamp yet, but reading through his policy platform, it seems like he's running on a very like fiscally responsible platform where he says he won't take a salary and he'll make sure that the USU is sustainable.
Okay.
Those sound like their policies some people could definitely agree with, but to me they sound like they're policies that come from more towards the conservative side of politics, so something on towards leaning towards the right, where people value keeping budgets balanced. You said that you're not political, but do you agree with those kinds of policies of Duchamp?
Maybe part of it. I think Duchamp also have some policies for international students. I think I agree with that kind of policy. I agree with the policies of Duchamp that's beneficial to international students. But for others' policies, I don't think I have right to judge them.
In terms of policies that are beneficial to international students, do you think all international students want the same things?
Not the same thing. So as a candidate, I have asked a lot of international students around me. I asked them what they want, what they need. So I try to find what they want and
just in terms of, like I said, obviously you did mention your top three there. Have you started negotiations for preferences, voting preferences?
We're in the process and still under negotiation.
Oh, okay, yeah. So you haven't decided anything yet? Yeah.
Who do you think you'll lean towards in terms of preferencing?
I'm not sure because my campaign manager do that for me.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
Who are your campaign managers, actually?
Jackie He.
Right, okay. Is she also active in the Chinese development, the Students Development Society?
He's a member of that society.
Right, cool.
Yeah. And out of the candidates that are running this year, are there any that you think you couldn't work with? And if so, why?
I couldn't work with?
Couldn't work with.
You mean my policy or something?
I mean like someone you think that you might not be able to work with in terms of the people running.
You mean the candidate?
Yeah.
I'm not sure because I don't have too many connections with the candidate.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Is there any candidates that you sort of agree with less in terms of their policies?
Oh, I think everyone is good.
You think everyone's good? Okay, yeah. So no one's used any...
No one is better or no one is worse.
Okay, yeah. And then just as well, in terms of, obviously, are you aware of the USU executive elections?
You mean the past?
How the USU has to elect their next president. So since you're going to be elected to board, you'll be...
Oh, in next few days?
If you get elected to board...
Okay, yeah.
Yep, then after that, there'll be the election of the new USU president.
Okay.
Out of the five board members that were elected last year.
Mm-hmm.
So do you know who... Have you given any thought to who you'd be supporting in that upcoming presidential election?
Oh, I have no idea about these things now, but if I get elected, maybe I will know more and decide in the later.
Yeah.
Do you know who the current president is of the USU?
Courtney?
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah,
because she gave us a speech in the candidate training session.
Yeah.
Yeah, I know her.
So Courtney's the president who will be leaving at the end of this semester. So
mm-hmm.
there'll be an open election for that if you get elected.
Yeah.
Interesting. So in terms of some of the board's recent policies and initiatives that have come out just this year, there have been a couple of things which are controversial, and we thought we might get your take on them. One big one has been a change to the way that alcohol is funded for clubs and societies. Do you know anything about that policy?
I don't know too much about that.
So under the new policy, clubs can only get funded for alcohol for the events that they run if they run those events at a USU outlet. So they'd have to go to some cafe owned by the USU that sells alcohol and buy the alcohol there, which would restrict them to Manning Bar, Herman's Bar, or Courtyard, effectively. Whereas in the past, they could get funded for alcohol purchases like anywhere. They could go off campus, like to a bar on King Street, for instance.
Okay.
Do you agree with that policy?
So now, the new policy says we can only get the alcohol from the cafes or bar under the USU?
Yeah, you can only get funded for it. So the USU won't give money if clubs buy alcohol elsewhere.
I'm not quite sure. I think maybe because the cafes is under USU's, that's right?
Yeah.
Okay, so yeah, maybe I think if students can drink in the campus, it's safer than outside.
Okay. There was a lot of criticism about how the policy was introduced. So a lot of clubs and society executives said they hadn't been consulted. How would you see the role of the USU board in working with the club and society executives if you were elected?
For me, I think one of the benefits of this policy, like we just said before, I think it's safer to drink in the campus because the society is under, yeah, it's under control of the, under the management of the USU. So I think USU should be responsible for the safety of every student. Yeah.
But for instance, if it came to a different policy that the board had to decide on affecting clubs and societies, how would you see the role of the board in liaising or speaking to those clubs and societies? Do you think the board should take into account their views, or should it do what's better in the board's opinion, even if the clubs and societies disagree?
But I think this is not my policy. So if it's a policy of someone else, they are responsible. They are responsible to talk with the societies. Yeah.
If it were your policy, like if there were another policy,
another policy.
Say yeah, just another policy which you felt really strongly about, but clubs and societies disagreed with. Will you change your view?
I'll communicate with them. I'll tell them why I think we should practice this policy, but we will have a communication, and it depends on the situation.
Cool.
I'll respect all the societies.
Yeah, makes sense. And then the other sort of board policy that we wanted to look at was, do you support the board's affirmative action policy?
Okay.
So that's the one, do you know about that, where...
For the women,
yeah. So in five directors, there has to be two women identifying board directors. And in a year where there are six directors elected, three have to be women. So
okay.
Do you support that policy?
Yeah, I support this policy. Yeah, because... because I think in the past, it's usual for men to in a dominant position in politics, but I think it's very necessary to hear hear the voices from different groups, like the gender group, male or female. So I think it's necessary.
Yeah.
Yeah. So I support it.
Yeah. And do you think you'd support a similar AA policy for international students?
For international students, I'm not quite sure for this one because I think. It's important for international students to know more about USU, but I think it really depends on the support base or the voting base. So maybe not.
Maybe not.
Yeah.
Okay.
What do you mean it's dependent on the voting base?
I think the voting base and the support base is the same for every candidate. From international or domestic, so they will campaign for their election. So I don't think the AAA or AC AAA for international students is so necessary. I think if international students have more access or have more information about the election, if they support our policy, they will vote for us. Yes, so I don't think AA is so necessary for international students.
Couldn't you make the same arguments about international students that you just used to support AA for women, that international students have been oppressed on campus?
There are two different things, because women and men is a gender problem, and the international students, I think, it's not so... Yeah, it's different.
Cool. Another policy we're interested in getting your take on is recent changes that the USU made to its polling stations for the upcoming election. So you might be aware that the board closed a couple of polling stations. Have you heard about that?
I have a little bit about it. Can you introduce more to me?
So there used to be a polling station in the Merriweather building, which
okay.
has now been closed. There used to also be a polling station in the International Students Lounge. That will only now be open for pre-poll. It won't be open on the election day itself.
Can I ask the reason why we closed that?
So the reason that was given to us was both those locations were unsafe, that the
Unsafe?
Meriwether polling station was on the top of a flight of stairs and the International Students Lounge station got really crowded during election day. Obviously, like Hengji Sun, the board director, during the debate over that those polling booths raised the possibility that this would disenfranchise international students who wouldn't necessarily have close access to polling booths. What do you think about these changes? Do you support them?
Well, I think, of course, if we close the voting points for Meriwether, maybe some international students won't vote because it's more trouble for them to vote in somewhere else. Yeah, it's certain. But I think if the reason is about safety, yeah, I think it's reasonable because the safety is the most important thing for students.
Why do you think international students vote in USU elections at all, or in the past? What do you think their motivations have been?
I think in the past, international students didn't pay a lot of attention about the student politics. But I think from 2016, the Coco Kong, she has encouraged us to participate more into the uni. So I think more and more international students know about the election or student politics. And I think most of us want international students to be better and have a better experience in the uni. So I think they will vote for the representation of the international students.
Another policy, I think the last one which we're interested in hearing your opinion on, the USU last year voted to stay open during a couple of strikes that were being run by the National Tertiary Education Union, which is the union that represents all employees of the university. Would you, as board director, vote to participate in the strikes, or would you vote to keep the USU open, keep it working?
Sorry, I have no idea about this question because I don't know what the policy or the story about this one.
Right, so there were a series of strikes, industrial action last year, being run by members of a union that represents employees of the uni. And during those strikes, the USU voted to stay open, so it didn't participate in the strike, it didn't close its offices, even though the rest of the uni, like all academics and professional staff at the university, didn't come to work that day. Instead, the union, the USU, said that no, we will come to work today. So they didn't participate in the strikes. They didn't join in with the rest of the tertiary employees on at UCID. If you were in that position, would you vote to keep the USU open, or would you vote to participate in the strikes?
Maybe I think USU is more students organization is more about students, so I think students benefit is the most important thing for USU.
So would you keep it open, or?
Sorry, I'm neutral on this question.
In terms of the USU existing to benefit students, can students be benefited in more ways than just, for instance, being given access to services or food? Is there a role for the USU to engage in like political action and activism?
I think USU can practice more policies which are beneficial to all the students. Like, can I see some of my policies?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, because one of my policies is shared charger box. I think the charging station in New Law Library is a charging station for my for mobile phone. I want to increase amount of this kind of charging station and add some laptop charger. Yeah, in main libraries. I think it's useful and helpful for a lot of students. So, yeah, I think this is kind of benefit that we can provide to students.
In terms of,
Oh yeah, sorry, but beyond that, like obviously the USU can give services and they can give students actual like physical things, but what about the USU actually campaigning for students on a political level? So trying to sort of get, for instance, say like campaigning for international concessions for Opal cards or something like that. Does the USU have a role there?
international students open card?
Yeah, well, like just in general, like in just for public policy in general, like for politics, does the USU have a role to sort of support students that way?
I don't know the international students open card is activism or.
Because we can't, you can't do it at university level. You'd have to campaign to the government to get that done, for instance.
Oh, well, it's a higher level.
Yeah, exactly. So does that something that the USU should take on, or is it something that we should just leave to the government, for instance?
Well, I think if the policy is good for students, it's good for the uni, I think we can have a communication with the government and have a negotiation. Yeah, I think we can have that one.
How do you define what's good for students, given that different students have different views?
Because I think the good thing for students is that whether if they had a good experience in uni, and I think that is also the mission of the USU. Sorry. Yeah, USU's mission is that provide a better experience of the uni in Australia. Yeah, so I think good thing for students is are students happy to study here, or do they enjoy their life in uni?
But given that some decisions that the USU makes will make some students happy and other students unhappy, how do you weigh those two things up? So for instance, with the alcohol policy that we were talking about before,
yeah.
That decision obviously has the capacity to bring a lot of added safety. And that might make a lot of students happy. But also, there are members of clubs and societies who used to enjoy events held off campus and could get alcohol funding for it.
Mm-hmm.
So they'll possibly be made unhappy by the policy. How do you weigh those two things up when there are competing interests?
Well, I think we can't let everybody be satisfactory about the policy. So we want to maximize the most of students' benefits.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, and then we'll have a look at your policies specifically,
yeah, okay.
And you as a candidate as well. Look, one thing that we did mention in your candidate profile is that you don't really list too much experience on there. What kind of experience, or do you have any experience at all that would qualify you to run a multi-million-dollar organization?
I think my experience is that the CDS, the society, yeah. That's my experience.
So what was your role in that society?
I'm just a new member of that society, and I work for them, but I don't play any important role.
Right, so you don't have an organizing role,
yeah.
In that society.
Yeah.
So in terms of the USU is, as Elijah mentioned, like a multi-million dollar organization. There are books of account that need to be looked at, like major decisions that govern how it's run, how it spends its money. Do you think you're qualified to take those decisions?
I think the experience is certainly important, but it's not the most important thing. Well, I think your passion, your energy, and whether if you really want to do something for others, I think these things are more important than you have experiences.
In terms of like the day-to-day work of a
yeah,
board director,
yeah.
My impression is that a lot less of it is implementing policies they're passionate about, as good as those policies might be, and a lot more of it is overseeing how staff perform their tasks, performing basic like governance responsibilities, effectively working as an administrator and a general manager of, well, a strategic manager of the USU. Do you think passion helps people be good strategic managers, or do you need to have a more like experience in organizing roles?
Yeah, because I'm passionate and I'm energetic, so I want to learn, I want to be better. So if I like some experiences, I'll communicate more and learn more from people who have experiences and skills. Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah. And then we'll go through your policy specifically. So your primary policy is the shared the smart uni, the shared uni
mm-hmm.
policy there. So the laptops, the mobiles, the umbrellas and the computers. One thing that we do notice about the power banks is that, as you mentioned, the university already does provide fixed power banks in
mm-hmm.
its library. Why should the USU put out money for a power bank loan scheme, and also students can just bring charges to uni for those
I just delete the policy of the power bank. So my policy just increased amount of the charging station, like the new
library. Oh, okay,
it's
more
yeah.
charging stations.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah. Well, look, in that case as well, you know, you say that they're trying to increase the locations of it.
Yeah.
The USU actually only owns a limited number of buildings on campus. So it's just Wentworth Building, Manning Building, and then the Home Building. And they're not teaching buildings. They're mostly buildings that have sort of the food outlets and whatnot. So you would have to, would you have to enter into a licensing agreement with uni to put like charging stations in other places?
Well, because I think adding some charging station is won't cost too much, but it will benefit students a lot and bring them a lot of convenience. So I want to practice that because it's good for students.
Yeah. The thing is, though, obviously the USU actually only owns buildings.
Yes.
Like I said, three buildings there. So to, if you want to increase, you're only increasing it to such a small area, and these aren't actually teaching buildings where people are studying and whatnot. So how then do you negotiate? How then do you plan on going about increasing it to other places as well, considering the university owns most of the other buildings and the university is separate from the USU?
Yeah, I know that.
Yeah.
So, yeah, I'll have a communication with the university. I'll tell them it's a good thing and we want to do that. Yeah.
Cool. In terms of your other shared policy, which is, I think, for shared umbrellas on campus, is that still a policy which you're going to run with?
It's still my policy.
Can you explain how that would work?
I think we will put some umbrellas or calculators, like something else, in the USU dominate buildings, like Wentworth Building or Holmes Building.
Mm.
Yeah. So if you are a access member or if you are a student of Sydney Uni, yeah, you can have a free borrowing of that kind of stuff, and just register your access number or student ID and return it back later.
So the SRC already, which is an organization separate to USU,
yeah.
already offers calculator loans for even for students who don't have access cards. So they can come to this office here,
okay.
borrow a calculator for free. What is your policy add in addition to that?
Yeah, because I assume it's a exam condition, so especially for the midterm or the final week, because I think one time I forgot to bring my calculator, so it's trouble. But at that moment, I don't know the SRC offers a calculator for students. Yeah, but I just want to provide some convenience for students in the urgent condition if they forget to bring them. Yeah.
But that would only be restricted to students with access cards, presumably.
I think students of access cards or students of the Sydney Uni. Yeah.
Do you think the USU would extend the policy to students who didn't have access cards?
I'm not sure. Maybe they will.
Mm. In terms of the umbrella policy, how do you see that working? Can people only keep the umbrellas on campus, or can they take them home?
They can take home and retain it back maybe in the second day.
Do you think people would actually bring the umbrellas back?
I hope they can.
Yeah.
Yeah, because we would register their access number or student ID. So I think we have their information. And I think the concept of shared uni is to encourage the sharing.
Mm.
Yeah.
I mean, it's a nice concept, but the way that I've seen it working with O-Bike, for instance, is that a lot of people damage the bikes and don't really take them back where they're meant to go. So do you think something similar would happen with umbrellas?
It could be happen. So we will think about more about this, yeah, to prevent this kind of situation.
Would the services be free?
Yeah, be free.
Would you have to put down like a deposit to use them?
Mm-hmm.
So you'd have to put a certain amount of money on the app, like a deposit, so that...
No, I don't think... I'm not sure, maybe... But yeah, but now I just have this kind of idea.
Mm.
Yeah, for later I'll think about more how to practice
work
it.
Out logistics.
Which is on that. Have you worked out like financially how it would be a viable sort of policy? Because the thing is you have the cost of developing the app and then also like getting the goods and stuff as well. And then do you think that is something that's financially sustainable for the USU to pursue?
You mean my policy of shared uni?
Yeah.
Yeah, I think for the shared uni, maybe USU cannot make money from this. Yes, because I think it's purely providing some convenience for students.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The USU can't make money from it, and presumably the money has to come out of somewhere else in the USU budget. So where would you take that money from?
You mean I can't take money from the USU budget for the charging station?
You can,
You
but
can,
the
but it
budget
has to
is
come from
limited,
somewhere
so you'll
else.
have to reallocate the budget somehow.
Yeah, because as I mentioned before, I think the charging station won't cost too much. Yeah, so I
Well,
think it could be okay.
presumably it will cost something, so you'll have to reallocate that money no matter what. In that, unless you said that the policy won't make any money for the USU, so there's not going to be more money coming into the budget. That means that in order to for this policy to be brought about, you'll have to take money from somewhere else in the budget. So what other program will you take money out of?
Well, I think if we have some more interesting events or activities, it would encourage students to be the access member, and USU can make money from increasing members of access card.
Given that in most years, like the trend has been downwards in terms of numbers of access members, do you think that's likely to happen?
You mean the future?
Yeah, particularly given that costs of living tend to rise as well.
Yes, it could be happen, but the USU the USU should think about some way to solve this problem and encourage more students to engage in.
Yeah, the next one is obviously your secondhand market policy there. So that's going to be online, offline as well. You want to create that app to do the secondhand stuff. With that policy, again, is that something that is financially, can the USU benefit from that at all?
Well, I think maybe the students who want to sell or buy the yeah, because I think the students will have a place to sell to buy their to sell or buy their secondhand stuff. Maybe they can, yeah, maybe they can give a little bit money to USU
Yeah, but
to
then,
yeah to the place fee.
wouldn't people just, instead of having to pay the USU to get a selling space, wouldn't they just sell their things on Gumtree or Facebook Market?
Well, because I think the secondhand market could be a physical one and will be held in the Easter Avenue like a week. Yeah, because I think it's convenient for students. Yeah, because from my perspective, I really want to do something good for students and bring them convenience.
Yeah.
Yeah.
In terms of a similar policy then, one of your new policies which you don't have in your online policy disclosure statement is an international students career fair.
Yep.
Can you explain how that would work for us?
Well, so I think I will incorporate with some societies who have some internship or job opportunities and hold international student fair once a year or twice a year. Yeah.
And how would you target that specifically at international students?
Well, of course, I know the uni has an official career fair for all students, but it's still difficult for international students to find a job through this kind of career fair because we don't have PR or we are not Australian citizens, so it's still problematic. So I want to hold a international student career fair to create more opportunities for them to work.
But what makes the International Students Career Fair different? Would you invite the same companies? Would you just label it differently? Or are there going to be meaningful policy differences?
Oh, I know some societies has a connection with companies, yeah, or with companies or some other organizations. So as USU, I want to incorporate with this kind of society. Yeah, not only one, maybe a few of societies and hold a career fair. So for international students, they will have more options and choices to choose.
I'm still not understanding what's different about this from just a normal career fair. If you said the difficulty at the normal careers fair is that companies overlook international students because they don't have permanent residency, then surely the companies that you invite to the international students career fair will also say, well, we'd love to give you a job, but you don't have permanent residency, so it's not, you know, it's not economically advantageous. How do you overcome that difficulty?
I think for the this kind of for the preference of this kind of companies, I would prefer to companies who are welcome the international student to join them.
Right. What kinds of companies are those?
I think maybe some Chinese law firm or some big international firm that, yeah.
Is the USU going, I mean, like obviously the issues with non-residents and jobs is a little bit difficult. Is the USU going to have anything to safeguard people who sort of get jobs through those avenues?
I don't think the USU could promise to make a promise about you can get a job. I think USU just offer a platform.
Yeah.
Is this kind of initiative relevant to the majority of international students who are here on like short-term study visas? I mean, if a lot of international students are here to get a degree and in a lot of cases then go back home, why would they necessarily be looking for a job at an Australian careers fair?
I think we already spent too much to study here, and of course we want to experience more, include not only in study but also in work. So I think most of international students want to gain some working experiences in Australia.
Okay.
And then I think one of your last policies will be the U-Talk policy.
Yeah.
Why is this something the USU should pursue?
I think the U-Talk is more focused on the student speech. So I would like to encourage students to give a speech about their success or their excellent academic performance or their experiences, anything else that just positive to spread.
You mean current students or like
I
former
mean the
students?
current student.
Current students, okay, yep. And then so what qualifies someone to be an influential student?
I'm not mean the influential student. I think if you have positive experiences that or anything good to that deserve to spread, I think
Do you have
you
any examples of what might be a positive experience that someone would be talking about at one of these U-talks?
So for example, if students are top one students of some of a faculty, so I think he can share his academic experiences or how he gets this such a good grade to the students. Just share his experiences.
Yeah. In the policy platform for it, though, what you wrote was that it's about ideas worth spreading. Do you consider like how do you call how do you sort of justify that as ideas worth spreading essentially?
I think I would do some research from the students and find what is their interest. I think the student's interest could be a criteria for which choosing the speakers.
One of the other policies that you've got on the online platform is for arts exhibitions. Is that still part of your policy platform?
I think it's not the main part.
Sorry.
That's fine. Because I think the culture, a lot of students or candidates will, and also the societies will have the multicultural events. So that is not specific of my policies because I can incorporate with this kind of people or society and we can do this together.
Like the USU already runs an art gallery called Verge Gallery, which is I think just upstairs. And it also, in relevant to the other policy you mentioned, your international kind of bridge, your multicultural festival policy, it runs like International Students Week. How do you think that you would improve both of those facilities if those are things you're passionate about?
I would incorporate with US of course sorry. So I would incorporate with the societies or other kinds of organizations to hold a bigger event and to invite more and to invite lots of international students or domestic students to participate together. So I want to give some help and push it to be better.
Cool.
Yeah.
All right, I think that's about all we had.
Okay.
I will stop that.